Hi, everybody. It's Olivia Blanchard, the Brand Builder again, and welcome back to our discussion on how to get out of the recession without becoming a casualty of it. And yesterday we touched a little bit on the insanity of trying to do the same thing over and over and over again, quarter after quarter, year after year, and expecting different results. If you've been using the same tools, the same tactics, the same strategies, the same services for the last 3, 4, 5 years, even in the last 10 months, and you're expecting different results now, especially with budgets shrinking, you're crazy. It's not going to happen, and your business is going to continue to shrink, and you're not going to get anywhere. At some point, you have to take the initiative. You have to sit down, rethink everything, revamp, retool, whatever. But you have to start thinking like a startup again. Okay, now that the game has changed, now that the tools have changed, and you have to be aware that they have, now that our budgets and that our customers' behaviors have changed, how do we completely rebuild ourselves? Without completely reinventing the wheel, how do we take what works, make it work better? How do we take that what doesn't work anymore and make it work again? Okay, it's really that simple. But in order to do that, you have to understand that this is a real threat and that you have to react to this threat. And the best way I can think of explaining this or illustrating this is by comparing this recession to a grizzly bear. Okay, so basically we've all, as business leaders, business managers, whatever, we've been hanging out by the grizzly bear's cave for many, many years, and we knew it was in there, and we knew that it could come out eventually, and that it probably would, but we were kind of hoping that it wouldn't. Well, last fall it did, and when the grizzly bear came out, it was meaner, bigger, hungrier, angrier than we had ever expected, and it really took us by surprise, and the result wasn't really good. So at its inception, what we're dealing with here is surprise, and it's stress, and it's something that we hadn't really prepared for. We weren't ready for it. So initially, you have a fight or flight response. And that's what I'm seeing a lot of businesses still 10 months into this, still trying to deal with fight or flight. And most businesses on the client side and on the agency side chose flight, okay? And basically, flight is anything that's not fight. So wait and see, duck and cover, you know, run away altogether, shrink, lay people off, do whatever, not really reacting or doing anything differently is flight. And there's inherently nothing wrong with it. It's a survival mechanism. It's cool. If that's what you want to do, that's fine. You can run for the woods and wait for the grizzly bear to go back in its cave, wait for the crisis, for the recession to go away, and then come out again and hope that you can regain your market leadership. But the truth of the matter is that if you run that leadership, it's gone. If you were a market leader or one of the market leaders a year ago, and what you're doing through this recession is not facing the grizzly bear, you're running away from it, when you come back, someone else will have taken the initiative and someone else will have gained that market leadership position. Even if they don't have the numbers yet, they'll be well on their way to actually getting there probably in 2-3 years. So by running away, by choosing flight rather than fight, you are giving up your market position. And if that's an issue of survival, that's fine, but you have to understand that's the reality of it. Now, the fight response is very different. And the fight response is basically, okay, fine, screw it. I'm gonna find ways of defeating this thing, even though it's 10 times bigger than I am, it's hungrier, meaner, it's got big claws and scary. I'm just gonna stand here and I'm gonna figure out a way to actually throw it back in its cave or just beat it outright. And the fight response isn't for show. It's not just making a lot of noise and throwing sticks in the air and pretending. If you're gonna be in this fight, you better be in this fight, which means you better be in this fight to win. And winning is defined by success. And how you define success is entirely up to you. And success might change, or how you define success might change from 6 months down the road, 12 months down the road, 18 months down the road. It's okay if it changes. It could be more customers, it could be more adoption of your product, it could be more visitors to your website, it could be, you know, financially based, it could be not financially based. It doesn't really matter. There's no right or wrong answer. But the way that you define winning is the way that you define success. And in order to do either one, you're going to have to define success somehow. You're going to have to figure out exactly what you want to do, what you want to accomplish, how you want to come out of this recession. Or how you want to look as a company 6, 12, 18 months from now, whether the recession is there or not. At some point, maybe the recession doesn't go away. Maybe the adjustment of the market takes years, decades. Maybe 3 years from now, consumer spending is still pretty much where it is now. Do you still want to be in this position of like struggling and making ends meet barely, or do you want to be a market leader then? You have to adapt to this market. You have to adapt to the threat of the grizzly. You have to figure out how to beat it. Somehow, So that means sitting down, putting on your thinking caps, and actually innovating, actually taking the initiative to do something. And I guess maybe the third thing is also understanding. And it's very tied to the first question of fight or flight. But if you're in the fight, you have to decide what's in it for you. What are you in the fight for? Because if you don't have something specific to fight for, if you're just doing it for the sake of it, or because it's your job, or because, I'm looking at my calendar and my watch, I have 3 years till retirement, so I better hold on in there, that's not really going to work. What are you fighting for? What's your raison d'être? What's your objective? What's your purpose? You have to find that. And when I go back to the mentality of startups, and I talk to entrepreneurs who are basically like serial startup launchers, there's a hunger that I find there. There's an energy. It's full of initiative. It's full of life. It's full of spit and you know, piss and vinegar. They want to win. They want to be successful. They want to create something special. They want to create a new category or win somehow. And there's no fear there. Or at least if there's fear, it drives, it fuels that passion. It fuels that momentum. It fuels that ambition to actually, no matter what happens, no matter what the obstacles are, go out and kill that grizzly, or at least scare it back to its cave. So you have to recapture that. And the only way you're going to do this, if you really want to be in this fight, if you really want to come out ahead, is to understand what you're fighting for, what you're trying to do, what you want to be remembered for 12 months or 18 months down the road. What are you going to accomplish in this time, regardless of the obstacles? Okay? All right. Give that some thought. Let me know what you think. And it's getting dark, so I'm going to take off. All right, take care.